here tonight. All the proceeds from this event are going to the Migrant Clinicians Network. You might have seen them on your way in. They're an incredible organization that works down at the border, helping people seeking asylum get the medical care and legal help that they need. We're so
Shabaria. What? Shabaria. Sorry. Give her a hand.
Thank you.
follows through family trying to discover the meaning of America.
There was a time teachers. So there's been a lot of labeling, especially towards the Latin community, as people who came here to steal jobs, or that they're bad people, and you probably heard of these stereotypes because probably we are all human, so we probably face our own stereotypes. But especially with my parents who have worked, they're very extremely hardworking people. First off, they're very selfless because no matter like how early my father has to wake up in the morning or how much my mom has to hear a lot of me nagging about schoolwork or anything like that, it's really nothing compared to what both my parents have done for me and my brother, who are inspirations to me. Especially since they've always taught me to be honest with people and to never lie to them and to always be kind to people, even to those who might not deserve the kindness back. As well as they would always tell me to always work hard for my dreams, not to take it the sheep way out, and instead, no matter where we are in life right now, that they always want to remind me of where I came from. And yes, I was born in America. I've never visited Mexico before because both of my parents are undocumented. So that means that if they go to Mexico, then they can't return to the U.S. You guys will just sit down and have a talk.
doing so much and supporting, but there's still more you can do, like buy baked goods from the bake sale to help donate more, and pins and just donation boxes are all around, so every dollar that you put in, like Vanna said, counts a lot, and it really helps, and it all goes towards families detained at the border.
Yeah, and if you don't have cash, we do take credit cards.
Exactly.
So, and checks, so no excuses.
But make sure you make all the checks out to Migrants Clinicians Network if you're going to make checks out to anyone. Next up, we have Anneke, Angstadt performing Rise Up, written by Andre Day. Give her a round of applause.
to support children and youth on the U.S.-Mexico border who are dealing with trauma and health issues. And I don't know how many of you work in the nonprofit world, but this is not an everyday occurrence. I mean, not like this. So the staff member who received it sent it around to the rest of staff, and there was sort of a flurry of emails then that went around that day. And, oh my gosh, this is so cool. This is amazing. Who are these people and where are they? For those of you, most of you don't know our organization. We're small, but we have an international scope, and we work nationally. We have offices in several different places around the country. And so one of our Maryland staff members, I remember her saying distinctly, I don't know where they are, but I sure hope they're on the East Coast, because I would love to go to that concert. Luckily, for those of us in the California office, they happen to be based here. And I have to tell you that email arrived for us at a moment, it really came as a ray of light for us at a moment when we were feeling a lot of anxiety and stress for the clinicians that we work with, and most especially for the immigrants and other vulnerable populations that they are committed to serving. For the past 2 years, we have heard from clinicians who work all over the country variations on this theme, which is, my patients are experiencing increasing levels of fear and stress. My family, the families that I work with, are feeling increasingly isolated and are confining themselves to their home and work. Families are no longer feeling welcome in their communities. They don't feel safe in their communities. They're disengaging themselves from their communities, and that this is leading to greater stress and anxiety among the people that they care for. And then very directly, the chair of our board of directors is a woman named Marcia Griffin. She's a pediatrician on the U.S.-Mexico border in Texas, and she is seeing increasing numbers of really desperately sick children who are either separated from their parents or in detention, really at critical moments in their illness. So for people that work with immigrant populations, this has been a period of time in which we really feel under siege and very frightened for the people that we see as some of the most vulnerable in our society. And we really desperately want to shine a light on all that is positive about immigrants in this society, and to change the narrative to look at how immigrants are contributing in a positive way and in the strength and resiliency of the immigrant population. MCN has always stood firmly for health justice, for immigrants, for the vulnerable poor, for other vulnerable populations. And for over 30 years, we have we've spoken loudly and consistently about the need for healthcare access, for human rights, and for workers' health and safety, and for family togetherness. As Marcia Griffin, our board chair, says, we must remain hopeful and that we are all about family values. So for us, you can imagine, it was this amazing thing when we discovered this group of young people that not only could see the true humanity of immigrants, but felt compelled to do something tangible in support. And their motivation and their excitement came at a time, really came, as I said, as a ray of light in a time that was feeling very dark to us. who sent the original email.
you to James Connallon. Been in contact with us.
Thank you.